Hi, I'm Seth Rotenberger, and today I'm going to be showing you how to get started creating animations in NX's Animation Designer. Using Animation Designer, I can quickly and easily see how my design fits together and view the motion created from it. Let's begin by making an animation of this saw. Let's start by opening up the Animation Designer tab and displaying the Animation Navigator, which will show all the features we will use to create our animation. We can now begin by making rigid groups for the different components in the assembly. These rigid groups will allow all the components that make them up to all move in the same way. Here, I am putting the fan and motor shaft components in the same rigid group as they will rotate together. I can easily select the different components and place them in the different rigid groups. Each of these rigid groups will move independently of each other and be influenced by the joints we will add later. It's not just components that can be added to a rigid group. For instance, we can add this sketch line to our rigid group, as well as including the saw blade and shaft components. All of our rigid groups have been created, and we can view them in the Animation Navigator. We can easily differentiate the different rigid groups by using Rigid Group Color, which shows the different groups as different colors. Let's now add the different joints, which will allow our rigid groups to interact and influence each other. There are many different joints that can be used for each application. Our first one will be a fixed joint to allow the other rigid groups to move in reference to it. We can now add a slider joint, which is the final motion of the saw blade moving back and forth. We need to select the rigid group that we will move, and then the rigid group that it will move in reference to, which is the fixed plate from earlier. Let's now add a couple of revolute joints. We will start with this wobble shaft and have it rotate in the fixed plate. The vectors and points can be used to ensure how the motion object moves. We can now add another revolute joint, this time to the motor shaft and fan, that will allow it to spin in the fixed bearing plate. Again, we can make certain the joint is placed correctly using the shaft's outer face. Our last revolute joint will be between the wobble plate and the wobble shaft. Both of these rigid groups will be moving, so the motion from the wobble shaft will be transferred and influence the motion of the wobble plate. The final joint that will be needed in this setup is a point-on-curve joint. This will allow the motion of the wobble shaft to be restricted to a point on the curve. And because this curve was a part of the rigid group that makes up the saw blade and shaft, it will create the sliding motion that joint needs to move forwards and backwards as the motor rotates. Let's now add a gear which will allow the power of our motor shaft to be transmitted to the wobble shaft via their different joints. Different gearing ratios can be added, but here we will keep it 1:1. Using the Move Rigid Group command, we can see if our joints all work together and our solution is correct. Here, our solution is working, and the saw blade is moving back and forth, as it is supposed to do. Finally, we can add a speed motor to the revolute joint that we added previously between the motor shaft and the fixed bearing plate. Our entire solution has been created, and we can view the motion from the joints and motor. We can see how the motion from the motor has been transmitted from the motor shaft and through the different joints to make the saw reciprocate. Let's recap what you have seen. You saw me open up the Animation Designer tab and Navigator, and then create the different rigid groups for the components that would move together. I then placed joints between the rigid groups to fix how they would move in relation to each other. We then added a gear to transmit power and a motor to create motion. Finally, we hit play and viewed the animation in motion. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.